So our journey to Australia started, and we just landed in LAX. While we're on the plane, funny thing, a gentleman comes up and goes, "Bashar, yo, it's a pleasure to meet you. We just came back from a show. We got a Beanstalk daughter with us." So actually, I'm gonna show you guys small world. You're on a plane flying across the world, and you run into someone. But look at this girl. Let me get her on camera. It's one of these dogs you gotta see in person. Beanstalk daughter. I mean, when I tell people Beanstalk, the best producer of all time, people don't understand.
Absolutely.
She is as wide as a... She put males to shame.
Hey, brother. A test. I want to kill them.
Sydney, Australia now, and we're about to catch the next flight to go see Jamie. Just landed in Adelaide, where Jamie lives, and now we're heading over to find our driver, and we're gonna spend some time in Adelaide with Jamie, visit up the Mustang Kennel. Let's go check it out.
The driver, and Jamie gets him out. Let's go. So this is our hotel key. So we're now finally going to our room, and we haven't seen it yet. So this is gonna be the surprise that Jamie has set up for us. He has been such a host, it's incredible. Everything has been great over here. They're training us like royalty, like I said. He went far and beyond, and now we have a tea time coming up here in an hour, so we haven't even got a chance to get in and settle and change.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. The bags are here. That's good. Oh, look at that view. Jamie definitely went all out. This is a beautiful hotel. Very different. We're locked in. Can't get out. They don't trust us. There we go. Video me while I'm videoing you.
This is Bashar doing Bashar.
This is what we do. So Jamie and Aaron got us something called tea time. Is that what it was, babe?
Yes.
Tea time. That's what they called it. Which is, I guess it's an English thing, right? But we're on Australia. It is a colonized country by England. Regardless, so we about to receive these cakes and teas and whatever it is, and we're excited. We don't know what it is, but they're bringing it to our room. They're setting us up so we can have a little bit of tea time. So because we're not used to the time change, we're up in the middle of the night. I think it's 4 a.m. We've been up for hours. But the view is beautiful, and the weather is gorgeous, and just showing you guys a little bit. So I wanted a coffee, it's 4 a.m., and apparently our hotel is attached to the railroad. So there's like a secret door, it's so cool. And it went right through the door, and here's the railroad. And so we're up too early. Even the coffee shop won't serve us coffee. They said they don't open until 6 a.m. They're just prepping, I guess. So we decided to walk around and leave the railroad station and kind of walk outside and see what's going on. And we haven't really seen the town, and it's really beautiful. I mean, we're on the water here. If you guys can see it or not, give you guys a little bit better view. So today we are meeting up with Jamie and Aaron. They have a surprise for us. I have no idea what. So we're told to just come downstairs. The driver will pick us up, and we're gonna have some sort of adventure-y journey or something like that. Let go. Hey, okay, I know I'm here
to stay. Counting on my wins, so I can't play it safe. Jamie Ding, my Muscle Tone Bully's Australia partner. He said that we can't come to Australia without going to see him. Traveling halfway across the world, 12,000 miles, we gotta come see him. So he organized this whole event for us. It's a complete surprise. We had no clue. So
everything's been a surprise.
And they went all out. You know, they had all kinds of stuff set up at the hotel for us. This is wonderful. We're having a great time. Okay, it ain't no problem. See, I can mold this thing like pottery. Better bet it, I'm a bet on myself. And for the top, and I don't need your help. We set the tempo. We run this thing in tempo. Let's go. Boy, I'm locked in. Know your place, I'm top 10. And all my haters watching. So you know I keep on clocking. Let's go. Time, my whole style of go. Mine, take my place, I hold mine. Run up, then it's go time. It's show time. Whoa. Yeah, they know I'm the one that set the trends, y'all. Tell them tenfold, I'm gonna change the tempo, okay? Tell them I can't play it safe, got more wins on the way. Gotta show them how to do it, man, my team making plays, okay, your team better play off. Sleeping on me, wake up, too easy just to lay off, okay? Tell me who you know can do it better. I know, they know, we know I'm a trendsetter. Hey, okay, I know I'm here to stay. Counting on my wins, oh, I can't play it safe. Keep playing, trying to go against us, get you out the way. Go hard, it's the only way to play. Let me say, I'm a trendsetter. I'm a go-getter. Okay, so we're out seeing kangaroos in the wild. And there's one right there. I got my boxing gloves. That's a big one. I've never seen a kangaroo in the wild before because I've never been to Australia. he got scared. So we're back in Sydney. We just went out to dinner to a Lebanese place. It was excellent. Suzette showed us a great time. Everybody was so wonderful. We're now back at the hotel. They booked us at a beautiful hotel. My style. Got beautiful cars everywhere. Okay, so now we're gonna walk around the harbor right in front of our hotel. So we just came down, give you guys an idea what it looks like. Sydney's beautiful, guys. Australia's gorgeous.
right, today is Sunday. So today is the day of the show. So it's going to be a big day. So obviously we have not been able to catch up on the time change. So we're up every day at 4 a.m. exactly, sometimes 3. And pretty much falling asleep early, not being able to enjoy the nightlife. We're gonna try something today though. Gonna push through it. So we'll be heading towards the show. They'll be picking us up in about 2 hours. So we're just gonna head over and get breakfast first by the waterfront. So we've noticed that in Australia people sleep in a lot. Obviously we're up a little earlier than usual, but I mean in the States you can get breakfast at 6:30, 7 o'clock. Here nothing's open, though. Everything opens at 8 a.m. You know, even during the weekdays. And I'm like thinking, like, people who want to go to work or to their office, how could they get breakfast beforehand or coffee? Even the coffee shops are closed. They don't open until 8. It's insane. We found one or two that are open like 7 or 7:30, but they were quite a walking distance. I think we just found one. Got a call from some people from the show in Australia, and we'll introduce you to them in a minute. And they invited me out to dinner, a splitter, to pick us up. I believe this is I hope it is. It said a black Sprinter.
Are you a bus?
Good. I am Bashar, yes. Okay, so we arrived to the Crown. I actually wanted to see this place. We hear a lot of things about it.
Great.
What's up, man?
You good?
Good, yeah. Trying to film for the episode.
Oh, yeah, nice.
So say something to the episode.
How you going, guys? Welcome to Crown, Bashar.
Thank you, my friend.
Put me on the spot.
Yeah, I put you on the spot. You gotta present yourself. Give him your kennel name. Give him your name. Give him something.
We're from Bully Syndicate Australia. We're gonna take Bashar and his wife out for some nice dinner and, chop it up with the OG.
Since we're in Australia, we're gonna have kangaroo, crocodile, everything else we have in the States. These are the two things we're gonna try, and I had to try it. It was part of the to-do list, and these lovely ladies made sure that I was gonna get it before I leave. So the show's over, and
we're doing it, right?
We're doing it, right?
We're all in.
That's it, we're all in. So, this is kangaroo, guys, and that is a crocodile burger. Kangaroo and a crocodile burger. All right, let's try it. You go first, bro. You're my witness. If you don't die, I'll have a bite.
No pressure.
No, I'm doing this.
I'm going straight for the roof.
All right, let's see this.
Can I get your bite?
Yeah, would you mind, my love? You girls not having one? Come on, you gotta have this. Looks good. Come on.
I can't eat kangaroo.
I know, because you got one. She's got a kangaroo at home, a little Joey. I'm eating her Joey right now.
That's terrible.
Hey, Joey.
That is actually
good. Hey, Glenn.
Yeah.
I like kangaroo.
Yeah.
You're going to be a little hoppy tonight.
She's never going to let me at her house. I'm never going over. But Joey's going to go missing.
You're going to wash it down with prayer.
That's pretty good. Crocodile now, come on.
We can't go better than that.
Let's cut the crocodile.
Now, we live in Florida, we have alligator. But we don't have crocodile. Oh, we got crocodiles, but we don't eat them though.
That's a double burger for everybody. I don't think we usually cut burgers.
I try to have a koala, but apparently we're not allowed to eat koalas. They must be protected animals or something. I'm not sure why.
With the full bone? Oh, you lost one. There you go.
Ah.
It's your crocodile burger.
There you go.
I'll try it.
We tried a crocodile. Look at you.
It's a crocodile. It's like a whitefish.
Dude, that's the bomb. That is really good.
It's because it has a sweet sauce.
Mmm.
I'm alright with that. I can't do the
It's
room.
Really good.
So you're taking all my forks.
Sorry, my bad. I got one right here. I was
in your military all day and you lost me.
Pretty good, right? That's good stuff. Alright. We ate kangaroo, we ate crocodile. Now we can go home.